Facebook message us at any time. We will always answer within an hour. Get back to you if you've got any questions, unless it's at 3 a.m. Anyway. But we're very active on social media, so use that as a platform to contact us. It's very easy. You have to do everything they tell you. That's it, until the test is finished. If you refuse to comply with their instructions, it can be deemed as a positive test and you'll be disqualified. Alright? So, we haven't decided whether, you know, we will randomly test. Last year at one of the shows, we tested the fitness and bikini show. Another one, we tested the bodybuilding show. So it could be either one. But they will be clearly in their outfits. They will have clear identification. So the only thing you have to remember is that you have to do what they tell you. And just be prepared that they're going to follow you around everywhere until you finish the test. And as the test is, it can be, intrusive is the best way to do it, you know. So they will follow you by literally everywhere.
And they will watch.
And they will watch you do everything.
Where it comes from.
Yes. Yeah.
Just make sure they have more on the
floor. Sounds like they might see it.
Yeah.
It doesn't seem like much.
When you take hydration, they'll fly you full of water, and like I said, they'll stay with you as long as you take us. You know, it's not you're not under pressure that you have to do it within an hour. We've had an acid test. As long as acid test has taken 5 hours,
took me 3 my first one.
Yeah,
just gonna do it. I'm
about
staring at my pants.
But generally after a contest, you're dehydrated. You drink a lot of water, a lot of it goes straight through you as well, very quickly, and I'll apply you to look through it, a lot of water. But I reiterate, just make sure you do everything they tell you. Don't jeopardize your test in any way.
And also make sure the supplements that you're taking are okay for the competition.
That's right. I was going to touch on that now.
Go for it.
Yeah. So just be wary of your supplements in that week leading up to a contest. Generally, amino acids, protein powders, they're all fine. Alright? When we talk about pre-workouts, I wouldn't use any pre-workouts on the week before the show. I'll go off tangent a little bit, I'll talk about pre-workouts a little bit more. I would be wary of using pre-workouts as much as possible during your whole prep. Now, I know it sounds funny, but pre-workouts hit your adrenals. Now, as you get tired from your dieting and your training, you start hitting your pre-workout and need more energy. But all that can do after a while is give you what's called adrenal fatigue. When that happens, your fat burning will come to a stop. Like, it can come to a stop. So, beware of dieting hard, training hard, putting your body under stress, and then hitting it with high stimulant pre-workouts, which can then slow everything down. I've seen that happen. I've experienced it, you know. So use them sparingly, you know. And especially as the show gets closer, when you're starting to feel the shittiest, you most probably to use them less. Just to, you know, you want to preserve your healthy adrenals so your body will stay in the fat burning zone.
Natural.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Caffeine is off the list. Yeah. But with pre-workouts, especially overseas pre-workouts, look, there's no guarantee of what's on the labels in there. That's been the case. Pre-workouts can also give what's called a positive, a false positive. That they'll give you a false test, a positive test, but it can cause a lot of headache and pain getting that reversed, just because of the stimulants that are in there. So rule of the thumb, 1 week out from the show, I would go off everything. One, they're not going to help anymore. You've either done the work or you haven't done the work 1 week out. You should be ready 1 week out. So go off everything just to make sure that you're not going to jeopardize the test with something just silly that happens within a pre-workout. Hormonal products and test boosters and things like that. Especially if they're overseas products. diuretics, even over-the-counter diuretics, which are done by American companies, can have stuff in there that can cause a mildew test. Stick with Australian products, just the herbal diuretics from health food stores, work, and they're not going to cause any problems. If you have a trainer or a coach who gives you something that's in a plastic bag to take, and says you'll help you with training, leave. No, I'm serious. Don't use them anymore. Don't use them because, they're putting you in jeopardy of getting a positive test. And in the end, you're the one that's going to get shamed. You're the one that's going to be out of it. Not them. They'll continue and they'll continue prepping somebody else. But if you don't know everything your coach tells you, you ask why, what is it, why am I taking this? Just stay on top because ultimately you are responsible. Just like what happened to the Essendon boys. Doesn't matter what anybody else forces you to do, you've put it in you. So you have to accept that.